take dedication. Can't think of a better time to have a dedication than the voting day. So I'm gonna ask Tony and Jennifer if they'll come first and bring the baby themselves, and then we'll let the rest of the family come to the proper time.
Born and answered that God has given.
in any heart and soul which we possess for him, to signify to all the world that you desire to follow Jesus. And while we speak of dedicating our children to the Lord, the reality is that we really are dedicating ourselves to the Lord. In fact, each of you can only dedicate yourself to the Lord. I mean, it's impossible for you to dedicate Jennifer to the Lord. Jennifer, it's impossible for you to dedicate Ivy to the Lord. Just as each of us must be born again ourselves, so likewise, the only person that we can truly dedicate to God is us. You want for Ivy, however, to grow up and learn to love Jesus. And at the proper time of her life, that she should receive him as Lord and Savior. To reach that end will require that each of you stay focused and committed to serving the Lord on a constant and a consistent basis. Living for Jesus is not an event. It is a relationship. This event today will have little significance in her life unless you show her by example how to live in a relationship with the Lord. She will take most of her spiritual awareness from how important it appears to her that you value your relationship with Jesus. If Jesus is important to you, then he will also be important to her. If prayer is important to you, it will be to her. If the Bible controls your thoughts, your values, your morals, your lives, then it will also probably control her. If church is important to you, it will be to her. She will watch your example every day. Your first priority is that Jesus has given each of you, forgiven each of you your sins and saved you both. To fulfill this priority will require that you believe the Bible is the Word of God. You cannot have a relationship with Jesus without a relationship with his Word. They are the same. Do you believe this? Do you agree to the best of your ability to shape the home life of your child by your love, your words, and example, so that she will, at the proper age, supernaturally come to an open confession of Jesus Christ and follow him as her Lord and Savior? Do you both dedicate yourselves to him? And do you agree to be actively involved in consistently carrying her to a church so that she will learn to love the Lord's people and be committed to his church? Family members, those of you who want to participate, we invite you to come up at this time. And I ask you as you come to consider the question that I'm going to give. Listen, family members, will you help them through prayer, your own example of commitment, and faith in God's word to bring up Adriana unto the Lord? Adriana, Braylon, Jacobo, I hope that's right. Dear Helen, we dedicate you to God and to the service of his kingdom in the name of the Father and his Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now let's pronounce a blessing over her. Which one of you would like to do that?
Yeah.
because of the dedication of Adriana, we present to you this certificate and also this ceremony, so that you may show her as time goes on that she was dedicated from birth to serve Jesus. If you believe that and confess it and have nothing else except that, she will walk in at the proper time and she will give her heart back to Jesus. Amen. Thank God. Let me see. If I want to come, give a hug, you can. Things I've noticed over the years is that a lot of times how you start out kind of determines how you're going to end.